I want to talk about the bill I introduced this year, SB 347, which was a bill that was designed to provide energy efficiency measures and corrections for our most vulnerable citizens. Let me repeat that, our most vulnerable citizens. This is a pilot program that was going to expire in January 2029. And basically, Dominion Energy contacted me and I worked with them. They volunteered for the program. It only applied to their customers, very small group of people. And all the energy efficiency groups and environmental groups supported the bill. We had no opposition when it was presented. This bill was targeting low-income people, elderly people, disabled veterans. The people that couldn't be in a position to fix maybe a hole in the roof or a broken window in their home that caused them to use excessive amounts of energy. Now, oftentimes these customers are unable to pay the bill. So by fixing the problem, not only do we provide a better living environment for those people, we also are preventing a situation where someone will have a high bill they can't afford to pay. So I mention this because I think this was a good bill, and it was one that ultimately wasn't going to cost the taxpayers any money. And it was going to be for the good of our most vulnerable citizens. No opposition to the bill. One of the things that I want to kind of echo the comments of my colleagues is I never heard from the governor or his team during the legislative session about any problems in the bill. And prior to the veto, I never heard anything that there was an issue with the bill. I have tried to, in my 7 years in the General Assembly, have a brand that shows I'll work with anybody for the good of my constituents and the good of the Commonwealth. And I'll talk and work with everyone. And it's very unfortunate that this was vetoed without even a conversation. And I hope that that will be something that is learned and we don't do that in the future. Because again, I'll work with anybody for the good of the people that I serve. And frankly, trying to do good for the most vulnerable citizens, I believe is all of our charge. And frankly, those were the remarks of the governor at his inauguration. So I would ask that we please take a look at this and we don't operate without communicating with each other. That's not the Virginia way, and that's not the way that's good for the people we serve.